If you've seen some of my recent videos, you may have seen the Alfred backpack hanger. Comes in aluminum and stainless steel, long-lasting, eco-friendly, durable product. Link in the description if you want to get one. That got me to thinking about other products that could be redesigned in a more earth-friendly manner. I was thinking cell phone holder, wireless charger. Could be manufactured out of a molded paper fiber product, just like these egg cartons that you already have in your refrigerator. And I'm going to show you how together we can pull 30 million pounds of plastic out of the world's oceans.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Myself and many other creators across various platforms are banding together to attempt to raise $30 million to remove 30 million pounds of plastics from the world's polluted oceans. Head on over to teamseas.org, link in the description below. Do your part, make a donation, pick up some plastic, whatever it takes. Do your part to help save your planet.
Some useful tools for modeling in Bristol board, square, a steel ruler, tape, X-Acto blades, X-Acto blade handle of some sort, pencil, white glue, and a pair of scissors. And by the way, something like a utility knife is totally not appropriate for this project. I'm gonna use 100 pound Bristol board. I find this an appropriate material for sketch mockups, right? This is my first attempt at making a 3D prototype of what this object is. The material is not too heavy, easy to cut, and relatively strong, meaning it can support its own weight, unlike a piece of, let's say, copy paper, which can't really support its own weight. So Bristol board is sort of an ideal paper material to use for making mock-ups. It's like a cardstock. You'll notice some of these cuts are score cuts, meaning I don't cut all the way through the material. It's mainly to help the material bend, so I can bend it in a straight line exactly where it's supposed to be bent, but still have some strength and be connected to the piece. I use a white glue, a PVA. I find it gives me great strength and it works really well, dries quickly. It's ideal for this type of paperboard modeling. We're just making a couple of cuts here. I'm trying to get the folded pieces to be flush cut, meaning on the outside they'll be nice and smooth. There might be some supports in the back, and that's okay. I just want it to be smooth and nice looking on the outside. I use binder clips as little clamps, and that works really well for holding the paper together in place while the glue dries. This will be the second piece of the model. It's basically the back support for the phone charger, and this is where you would get your strength from to hold the phone in an upright position. And ultimately, we're gonna end up building this with some sort of wireless charging capabilities. Now, we're not mocking that up in this prototype. It's too early for that. I just wanna get a sense of the general form of the overall object, what it looks like, what it feels like, how tall it is, its visual proportions. That's the point of this mock-up. I'm not trying to build something with 100% functionality out of the gate. This is my first attempt, and I need to work out some visuals and some manufacturing issues. This is my attempt at that. As a designer, any project that I do, I'm gonna start with some sort of a sketch, some sort of a quick two-dimensional representation of what it is that I'm gonna build. In this case, this is a perspective sketch using some markers to give me a rough idea of what this thing is gonna look like before I actually build it. So any designer is gonna do some sort of a decent three-quarter view sketch, probably, maybe some side views to understand the basic proportions, to get an idea of visually what this part or product is gonna look like. And this helps me. I've done a bunch of other sketches before I even got to this one, and I'm gonna release this video a little bit later, in its entirety with some voiceover to talk specifically about my technique. But I just want to share this sketch with you so you can understand my process and see what I go through before I even get to building a model. So far, I've built two parts of the charger. The part that actually holds the phone and the support behind that that holds the phone up in the air. Now I need to build the base. This is going to be a molded fiber product. And molded fiber is basically cardboard that's been pulped and then placed onto a mold, dried, and it has pretty good strength, just like an egg carton that you saw at the beginning of this video. And we'll go through that process and prototype that out in this video series. But right now, I need to work out some of the details about how I'm going to pulp this and how I'm going to prototype this when I get to the pulping stage. So building the model in a way that I can actually manufacture it and prototype it in a realistic way is super important for me to understand and make this model in a relatively realistic way so that I know that I can actually mold this product in the end. That is, of course, the point of hiring an industrial designer, right? We design for industry, meaning we design for manufacturing. So when we design a product, we have in mind a certain manufacturing process, or we figure out a manufacturing process that can be used to make something that we designed. And in this case, I'm designing specifically for a molded fiber production process. Now you can see the slit where the top leg is going to slide into and support the phone. It's around this part that I come to the realization that I'm having some issues. The way this sort of outrigger is designed gives me a little bit of an undercut situation or a dialogue situation, which I see is not going to work for production. Now I'm going to finish the model and I'm going to have to build another one, and I got to figure out how this is going to work. But I have some other things that I need to work out before I get to that part. So I'm okay with that. I realize I have a situation I'm going to deal with, but I need to figure out this little detail here where the phone is actually going to rest on, and so that it sits onto the phone charger in the correct angle. So I'm going to build this. Now, another issue that I haven't quite worked out yet is how the whole thing connects together. And you'll see I'm actually using a piece of tape here to hold the whole structure together. Now, ultimately, I'm going to resolve that and figure it out. But for right now, this allows me to see the part in 3D, check out its gesture, its proportions, and visually see what it looks like. I like it. It needs some adjustment. It's looking a little top heavy, but that's okay. This is my first stab at this, and we'll make another model so we can make some adjustments. Don't forget to click the link below to go to teamseas.org so you can learn about how to take some of the plastic out of the world's oceans. In the next video, we'll make a chipboard mock-up that will have adjusted proportions and visuals, and we'll also start CAD modeling this so that we can build the mesh molds to paper pulp prototype this eco-friendly phone charger. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.